Welcome to my channel. I'm Jeremy68. Before we get started on the game today, I'd like to interest you in some coffee. Coffee Brand Coffee has a wide selection of flavored and blended coffees. They also have K-Cups, if you're interested in that, and a K-Cup filter, if you don't like the blends and coffees they have in K-Cups, you can buy other coffees and use a filter. They also have three Cocos. A fourth one is being sold out and taken down, but they're made with real cacao Cocos and very highly rated. They also have premium snacks. Many are marked down currently and will be removed when they get sold out. If you click on the link in the description below, you get a 10% discount on anything but the Roaster's Choice Coffee Club, which is a monthly club that gives you a new coffee every month from around Africa, South America. Each is specially blended and picked by the owner of the company, Jeremy. Also highly recommend it. You can get ground or whole bean. Whole bean, if you grind it yourself, it stays fresher longer. And they also have a club called Jeremy's Club that when you join it, every dollar the money you spend gets transferred into beans, and 100 beans equals $1. On the site that you can use further discount any items you buy. Now, let's see what we can look at. Today's game is going to be DayZ Banoff Map Part 2. We're pretty much leaving off where we picking up where we left off in the last video, at the Rabasi Airport. I think what I'm wanting to do next is head over to here just to see what we got. If I can find it. That should be south. Hold on, let's get a bunch of these markers off the map. Okay, so Rabbit, where's he? Let's turn that one off. Let's see what. Area 02. So let's okay, now we know where we're going. It's been a week since I've been here, so it might pay to see any military stuff to see, or medical stuff to stop off and pay it a visit, but right now I need to get clear in this military base. I've been playing on a different map, one from the earlier. Videos. Hold on to me, I ain't got room for Benelli. Need to eat something soon. Let's zoom in on where we're at. Where are we at? Okay. So the exit's over here. And there's a wall ahead of us. But the road should let us get out without too much trouble. If I can find the damn road. So we need to go this way to get to the road. I kind of like doing these map series on PvE servers versus low population normally. And second, it's much easier. Not have to worry about anybody running across trying to kill you if you're on a PvE server, so I can not have to worry about that while at the same time we can look at the map, the countryside and stuff like that, see what they look like. I am thinking I'm going to skip the official maps, Chronos, Plus, and Livonia. Or if I do them, it'll be at the very end. Although with the Chronos and Livonia map, the poll I did, I got 3 votes on it. All of them want me to do DayZ official servers, so that will probably be the route I'll take. And since I'll be on those 2 maps doing those series, those gameplay, I will might as well skip them. Now, one of the maps I just finished building a base on, and I might pull some videos from it. I'm not sure yet. I have been messaged by an acquaintance on the Ruster we've been playing on, and he says it's sometime this weekend or on the weekends, he wouldn't mind teaming up with me and doing some of the monuments on them. And if we run some monuments on that, I'll make videos of that. I think we need to do another wheel stop. It's a little bit out of the way, but nice countryside. I wonder if there's any animals I can get a shot at. This server's stamina does go down as you're running, just kind of slow it looks like. And also weight does affect your speed and stuff like that. Alright, time to eat. Where's my knife? I hear a goat. This way. And of course it's turning dark, so yeah, I don't mean you. Can't carry it all, so let's set this down. Eat this. Pick this back up. Grab that. we got some meat now. More meat, I should say. I'm gonna have to cook it soon, though. But it's turning night, and we're heading it to an area where we can possibly find a fireplace. Oh shit. To cook it very fast. Okay, let's stamina recover a bit. Would have liked to have found better backpacks and stuff, but so far, no luck on that. It looks like it's turning, since it's turning night, maybe we can find a building with a fireplace in it, and we can gather the stuff and make a quick fire and cook the meat and hold out there overnight. Looks like this house right here has one. Let's go in and take a look. Cook stove. It's faster than, or better than trying to cook it over open fire, but not by much. There we go. Find a sewing kit and a leather sewing kit. So let's go to the well. Clear any zombies. Or maybe there's something closer to the well. There's one. Potentially, let me look. Yeah. We're still 100 meters almost from the well. Do I have any containers? Yeah, that's cool. What's in the cooking pot? Okay. Not gonna put water in it. Where'd my gun go? No zombies. Moses. What caliber is it? 39.54. Which ones do I carry on me? Thirty-nine, so I don't need that. Don't need ammo either. Damn, that's in the direction I'm going. Alright, this ain't good. I don't see any bushes. I mean the sticks. This ain't working out very well. Is there a fireplace in here? Just a cook stove. That's no help. It's just a little bit bigger. Any paper on me? Or rags? Do I? Or nothing to craft with? Or maybe. Oh, great. Do I have any? Player or anything? All right, well, I'm going to pause it here. Wait until dawn, because it's not going to be very long till dawn. And then we'll start back up. I got to make up my mind how I want to do this anyway. I guess I just lay my shotgun down. I don't know how the hell that went from place it in the fireplace to making hand wrappings. Not sure on that. But, I'll go get some bark and stuff like that, and we'll cook up the food here in a little bit. But for right now, I'm going to pause it and let daylight come in so we can see what the hell we're doing. I'll be back in a flash. All right. We are back in at daylight. Think I'm going to drop my shotgun, go get some wood so we can cook up this food. Great. I don't know why, when I logged out, I didn't close the game all the way down. When I logged back in, now the toolbar won't show up on the bottom. It does that quite often with me when I don't log in, or when I don't close the game completely out when I log out. Let's go see if we can find that wood that we have gathered over here. Maybe it's still here. Yep. Make a couple trips on that. Should have enough to cook everything. Let's close up the doors. That way, if we hear somebody coming in, we'll know about it. Right there. In the meantime, we can eat this. Grab our panelli back. I'm going to try to smoke them and cook these. That's no reason to leave that intact. Got a heat buff now. All right. Let's hit the water one more time and then we head out again. Might be eat another one of these meats. Looks like he's about to lose. All right, let's head out. We got 8 kilometers to go. We should have plenty of food and water to cover it. Now on a normal server, I would not be running down the road, but since this is PvE only, I shouldn't have to worry about it. Not saying that everybody played rules, but they should anyway. Why is this here? There's nothing inside here. I don't even see a foundation. I understand that maybe there's some rooms or something, but there's literally nothing there. So I'm thinking Area 2 might be underground bunker. I don't know if you have to have a key card to get in there. So if we follow this road up to Satina, we can keep on going till we get close to it anyway. Damn it. Double pressing the button for some reason. Hopefully somewhere along the way we might be able to find a better backpack. The one I have right now is a 90 slot, so it's pretty good. I don't know if this has a mod that's got a bigger one on it or not. It's a long way to travel. Might just do the cut across country. I don't know if it's that time though. We will have to stop to do our eating and drinking because I gotta lay the shotgun down. Let's just go up and cut cross country. Looks like most of the weather will be fairly close to the road anyway. Kilometers is a long way to travel. It's a nice woodland anyway. There is a lack of animals so far. Right back at animals anyway. Anyway, might have to cut this a little bit short. I'm kind of waiting to hear from somebody on doing some stuff in Russ that I can get on camera. And maybe get a video out for that tomorrow. And then today or tomorrow I need to do a first DayZ video on official servers. Telephone poles on a little trail. Is there a road by these poles? Don't look like it. Just that one trail. That's weird. Those lights are like you'd see in this interstate intersection, or it's not as many of them, but something like you'd see in an arena or large storage area for industrial storage to soak in air. Brass knuckles don't work. It's just more crap. Jerry can, cool. Plenty of gas, I guess. Yeah, I need them. Missed with one, I can't believe that. One medium insulation compared to one best insulation. I'll keep the medium. Swap this out. I don't see any bodies of water between me and Area 2, so I'm back to cutting cross country. This is the only thing I don't like about going across country. Running across these rock piles that might get in the way. Nice town over there. Pretty hill country. Up there somewhere looks like it might be a nice place to put up encampment or base. Alright, let me set this down. What's the most worn? Eat a couple of these. Is there a road in this, or is that just what you call wind road? Not no road. Just wind right with the trees. That looks like a castle. Yeah, it kind of looks like a castle up there. Good place for it on top of that hill. The thing is, I like these modded servers because they like, most of them's got maps where you pull up the map, see where you're at and stuff like that. And to get a map on an official server, you have to actually find the map and hold it in your hand to look at it, which can be a pain in the ass. Good thing about official servers is if you don't log into the same server every time, everything you're carrying on your character and your characters move from one server to another. But if you don't log in on the same server, you get to go back to the fresh spawn area. Even if you have a base, you have to go back to the very spawn area. It's a pain in the ass. What's it going to look like on the other side of this hill? I see what it looks like, a bunch of dead trees ahead. We're inside 3 kilometers, so we traveled 5. I hear something in that direction. I don't know if it's a bear or a moose. Kind of too faint to tell. Anyway, when we're doing this, running here, don't forget to like, leave a comment, subscribe to my channel so that we can, my channel grows. If you like what I'm doing, it's the best way to help keep me going. Great green again. More dead forest. That's actually a decent spot to put a tower. Now that should look over a pretty good sized area down there. So it's kind of smart. Inside 2 kilometers, so we're getting there. I don't know if you need a key card on this server to get into bunkers or anything like that, or if it's not got that many mods. Okay, I'm going to take to silver. I guess it's not like this. Actually, now we're getting downhill a little bit. That's for the sky. guess we need to go to a building where we close ourselves up in. And I need to log out, close the game out, and log back in so I can get my toolbar up so I know which weapons I'm with. Because I got them all set up on different toolbars depending on the server. I'm going to hurry up and get somewhere where I can lay my guns down and eat. One kilometer. Does this road go into it? No. So this is about as far north on this map as you can get. So theoretically this should be tier 4 loot from this military base. And so we might be able to replace better. Base first, we'll do this way of it. That way if there is a key card, maybe we can find it on the military base and not have to go down and there and end it. We're an hour in, so, well, these videos, I normally have them an hour and a half to 2 hours, so we still got time. I just need to take a break here in a minute and get indoors. Military base should be here. Well, yeah, there it is. Don't see anybody here. Canned bacon. Ooh. That don't go off. Assault vest. Basically the same thing I got. Have you put your butt back? Is there anywhere I can use a holster? No. Yes, man, it's down here. Requires a key. Search this place, find the key, I guess. New tire repair kit. Zombies up here. Kind of need to be an entrance. Okay. Oh, these are tracer ends. These are not. So, I'm going to look around and go down the hill, but for now I'm going to log out, close the game, take a quick break, and then we'll go do some exploring as soon as I get done with the break. So, I'm going to pause the recording and I'll be back in a flash. Alright, let's take a look around. Okay, so I'm going to assume that's all underground, but we'll take a look. Go back this way and see if there's an entry back here. Okay, so now let me get rid of these. Okay, so now I need to find the key. are good flavors. Maybe. Okay, so we're at the edge of it. I don't see any. Bomber jacket is 30. Oh shit. Okay. Best insulation. Patrol jacket. There we go. Patrol jacket. Well, damaged. Worn. Dog mag. a pound of vodka, that'd be great. Did I check this one? Yeah, I did. Pardon me? I'm okay. Patrol pants 30, and my current pants are 30. They are pressed chain. Those are worn. I'll stick with my current. Smoke grenades. I don't have a grenade on for them. Damn, there's a lot of tents back here. Batteries. Not useful. There's a 380. If I had a mag, I'd probably grab it. Tracer. I don't need tracer rounds. I'm sure I say I still don't need. Fuel this, let's get 30. this one's got 30 is damage more. Yeah, we can go ahead and swap them out. Still use butt pack. Southward, which would mean putting these boats. This way, I believe. The problem is I need food again. Troll pants. Damn, there's never anything useful in these places. Need a shovel. That should stir up a hornet's nest. ACOG scope's only useful if you have it. If you have a fabric for it, which I don't have. Motor oil. Store just in case. No battery, damn it. Assume since it says universal, it means it's meant for Warsaw Pact countries, AKs, and the like. Yes, there's a battery. Gun cleaning kits always come in handy. Unbox them because you can stack more of them that way. $25 in a box, and you can stack 100 of them. So you condense 4 boxes into one. Some of these, they got spawn points on there. One server I was on the other day, I walked out there and looked, and there was half a dozen rifles, 2 or 3 magazines, all kinds of shit. Tactical backpack 63. I got food backpacks, so I don't need it. I was hoping for a butt pack finally. Wait, that won't work. Okay. And what the hell's the matter with? Through these rooms, I think. Nah, I prefer these. If the, I knew where the trader was, and I knew I could sell that to the trader, it'd be a good thing. Smoke grenade. Okay. Peel vest 30. I got one already. Great. Well, I didn't even see the announcement of it. Well, thank you for watching. We'll continue this in the next episode. It's been long enough on this one. And remember, like, share, subscribe, leave a comment. And I'll see you next time. Goodbye.